Well, here we are, only weeks before NAB, and Blackmagic Design has released a cinema camera 8.6 public beta update. Now, before we get into the update, we should discuss what this could mean for other Blackmagic Design cameras at NAB, because the most important takeaway from this update is what cameras were omitted from the public beta. The most important is the Ursa Mini line, which are ripe for a model refresh. I think this firmware update is the biggest indication that Blackmagic Design is going to refresh the Ursa or release another camera that will compete with the Pocket line. So Pocket users will be happier as they've received more functionality to their cameras before the newer model is released. But that's just my assessment of how Blackmagic Design markets, updates, and releases their new cameras. Plus, this update is going to drive a lot of attention to Blackmagic Design cameras before NAB and before they announce a newer model, which will further boost online traffic and sales. I mean, that's just marketing 101. Plus, the fact that they've dropped it with very little fanfare via Twitter indicates to me they don't want this very significant update to outshine whatever is coming next. Okay, let's just move on to the firmware update. As I said, it's major and has significant enhancements, but only for the 4K, 6K, 6K G2, 6K Pro, and 6K full frame cameras. The download is huge at 3.12 gigs, with the first improvement being direct camera to cloud sharing, where you can now use the USB-C port to connect a phone, then log into your Blackmagic cloud account and directly upload clips to a Resolve project. And there are a lot of people that are going to love this feature, as on the surface, it appears really cool. But what I would like to know is this a feature any of you are actually going to use? The second gives the ability to connect your camera as a USB webcam, which is great, but with the lack of continuous autofocus in Blackmagic Design cameras, I'm not sure how practical this will be, but maybe, just maybe, this is an indication of what might be coming at NAB, a camera with usable autofocus from Blackmagic Design, along with an updated video assist with inbuilt NDI and live switching capabilities. The video assist is one of Blackmagic Design's oldest products now, and in the last week, we have seen a push to promote and sell the current units, at least here in Europe. But what do I know? The last of the major updates is a huge one, and it has been an issue for Blackmagic Design since its very first camera, which is the lack of the ability to just delete files in camera. Well, that has now been fixed. There's plenty more, but these are the notable ones, but I need to properly test it all out before publishing a detailed video on it. And if that's something that you're interested in seeing, don't forget to subscribe so that you don't miss out on that. Now, before you rush off and start installing the public beta, please remember to use a freshly charged battery or plug your camera into the mains power while updating the firmware and follow the installation guide to avoid any problems. And if you like watching videos on Blackmagic Design equipment, I'm sure you'll like some of these videos here.
Swipe up. Tag your friends, like and subscribe, comment below. If I make this follow, don't let this flop, wait till the